Hi, Harry. Thanks for stopping for it. So you got into the Bride of Frankenstein story pretty quickly in season one. How does this progress, and what's in store for season two for Victor?
I haven't read the second season, so for me it's going to be a wonderful surprise. And I'm really interested to read it. We're going to get them in the next week, and then start filming mid-September. So to me, I'm blind as you are right now.
Well, this might be a question for Mary Shelley as much as you or John Logan, but at least in Penny Dreadful, do you see Victor as one of the heroic or villainous characters?
I mean, it's interesting. I think when I look at him as a character, if you look at him objectively, it's very, very different from if you're looking at it subjectively from the inside. So when I look at him removed, then it's a barbaric mental state of affairs. But from the inside, it's quite clear and kind of, you know, he's sound with his goal, and so I can look at it two ways.
So did you delve really deeply into the creature research, whether it was Mary Shelley or the famous Universal movies?
I didn't watch any films. I only read the novel. That was like the sort of pure like research that I did for it in terms of it, Frankenstein as a story. But really, there was more work, or as much work, in terms of the kind of medical background of this man and where he'd been to school and what he'd been doing with his time before we met him. So to look into the Victorian era and the medical sort of what was going on at the time in science and the breakthroughs that were happening then, that was fascinating, and that kind of framed it in a way that was useful to sort of start this journey, really.